love y'all. Every time I see y'all, I remind me of me and my mom, you know, her and her daughter, always a team on fire for Jesus. I thank you. I just want to let y'all know that we love you from the house of transformation in Athonia, Georgia. You're right next door to me, darling. Amen. And thank you all for coming out. Thank you for the powerful, wonderful words. Thank you, Mother, for dressing up so beautiful. Just to see your hat on in church, just to come to a church. Y'all don't understand this thing, because the devil is against churches. He's trying to destroy the church, because if he can kill the saint, then everybody going to hell. We got to wake up. We got to wake up, church. We keep preaching to the saints. We got to go out there and preach to the sinner, because that's where everything is. The enemy wants us to stay in the church and forget about the saints, because we don't want to spare them. We don't want to get near their sin. We don't want to spare their alcohol. We don't want them asking us for no money. We don't want them asking us, can you let me live in your house? We don't want to be bothered. Most of us don't even want to be bothered with our brother, sister, and have two or three extra rooms, and our own homeless, our own people are on the street homeless. But guess what? We dress up every Sunday. We look so pretty. We pay $1,000 for this preach on TV. We sow a seed and another $1,000 for this ministry, and we can't support our own brother that came from the same room, from our own mama, with the same seed from our own daddy. What's wrong with us, y'all? What's wrong with us? We need to get to know Christ for real. When we get to know Christ, then the world gonna get to know Christ. Oh, yeah. We are black. We're black. We're black. I don't care what nationality, what color your skin are. To right now, to every sinner, we all are black. And Jesus needs us to wear the red blood. I'm talking about that red blood. He needs to dip us in today. He needs to dip us in. This is supposed to be an evangelistic exposure, or just another church service. I pray to God that we all go out here and conquer and do what God needs us to do. We've been mingling too long. God told me to give every preacher in here a word. He said, give them that word of encouragement. No more kibbles and bits. No more kibbles and bits. Because see, kibbles and bits is made for dogs. When it was thought of, it was created to feed the dog. Amen. The dog inside all of us. We all have a bar. We just don't know what kind of dog we are. Some of us are German Shepherds. Some of us are Chihuahuas. Some of us, Lord Jesus, I don't even know the names. It's so many dogs. We all have a dog inside of us, but we get so settled with life because we see the situation, and then fear comes and says, you can't handle that. God didn't tell you that. Then your family go against you, and then everybody begin to pray against you. And woman of God, the reason why the church can't grow, because the people out there don't want real pastors. They don't want the real saints. They can't handle the real stuff. They want that stuff that's going to make their faith get cavities. No more eating the crumbs from their table. We as preachers, God called us to show them who he is. And we get so used to wanting to satisfy the members. Till we stop satisfying God. We got to begin to satisfy God. That's our commission. My commission is not to satisfy my mama or my sister or this preacher over here. And not your pocketbook. My promise and my thing that I'm supposed to do is to satisfy God. See, we got to understand, we got to keep God satisfied, because that's the only one that can grant us favor. That's the only one can give us grace and mercy. That's the only one can upgrade our life. That's the only one can promote us. That's the only one can pull us from. You got to understand, that's the only one going to help your child. That's the only thing going to help that marriage. We got to get out here. You talking about evangelists. We go to the movies. We go to church. We go to work. How many of us get dressed? Say, you know what, baby? We going to hit the streets today. You should have invited me to Atlanta. I don't ever come to Atlanta. But I got excited. That's why I was a little lost. I was looking at buildings. I was looking at the people. I'm the kind of person, I need to be in Atlanta. I've been in Latonia and a dead see, I was saying like that. I got a car where it is, where the people sitting out on the corner. You get what I'm saying? Because that's the kind of person I am. And so now that I saw that area, I thank you. I thank you, God, first. Hallelujah. Y'all better give God some praise. And if you don't mind, after I do this, we need to pray, because prayers of the righteous are better than much. We need an evangelistic explosion right now with the mighty name of Jesus. Right now, Lord God, we ask you, we plead the blood of Jesus on every church house tonight. Saturate every pulpit. Saturate, Lord God, the steps. Lord God, the parking lot. Lord God, the pastors, the preachers. Lord God, the musicians. Lord God, the instruments. Lord God, the doorkeepers. Saturate, Lord God. Saturate every late member. Saturate, Lord God. Prepare your house, Lord God, all over these nations. Lord God, for the word that's getting ready to be preached. Lord God, for the anointing, Lord God, from city to city, state to state. Help every preacher out. Lord God, even the lost preachers don't know what they want to do. They're supposed to be preaching the word, but want to kill themselves. Right now, I'm asking for you, Lord God, to go and erase those thoughts. Bring them back to your word, Lord God, that they shall live and not die. In the name of Jesus, have your way. Let us get away from dogs, Lord God. Let us get away from people, Lord God, that don't like us. Lord God, that close our minds, Lord God, that think ungodly things. In the mighty name of Jesus, let us know how to shake some stuff off. Lord God, and while we shake it off, Lord God, let us shake off some love residue to leave there. Lord God, for somebody to fall and ask for forgiveness. Lord God, let us shake off in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. A direction pattern to GPS you. Lord God, in the name of Jesus. So they can find their way to you. Lord God, when we shake it, Lord God, don't let us be bitter, but let us get better for you, Lord God. So your people, Lord God, in the name of Jesus can be saved. And don't let none of our work be in vain. In the name of Jesus, for every curse word, every song, Lord God, that's assigned to assassinate every preacher that you called, that you ordained, Lord God, that you created for purpose. In the mighty name of Jesus, we ask you to send every curse word, every wicked spirit, Lord God, we ask you to send it back to the pits of hell. Leave it there, Lord, and Heavenly Father, and assign new prayer warriors. Lord God, give them the right prayer warriors. They have prayed, they strength up in ministry. Lord God, in the name of Jesus, cut their cameras off. Lord God, and let us begin to go back to old-fashioned church. In the mighty name of Jesus, where everybody need to come to the church house to see. Lord God, be a part of the atmosphere. In the name of Jesus, begin to rearrange, Lord God. In Jesus' name, and let the world, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, see how good you really are through true worshipers. And let us be your true worshipers, Lord God, until we infect everybody that know us, that look upon us, that hate us, that love us, that want to be like us, that intimidate us, Lord God, that persecute us, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, till we infect them, Lord God, to be more like you. In Jesus' name, we pray.